Sunday morning. I understand Sunday is generally a day when it is kind of a slow day. I thought when you're going slow, that is a great time to ignite something. So let's start with ignite your sales funnel. Are you able to see the presentation? So maybe somebody could say a yes or no.
Yeah.
All right, fantastic.
Adulji, recording is on?
Yes, it is on. Yeah, recording is on. We are also live on Facebook.
Facebook. Okay. All the best. Okay.
All right.
Carry on.
Yeah. Okay. So my first question to all of you is, why are you here? All right. So, are you here because it is free? Well, I would say that's not the answer. You're not here because it's free. These are some of the reasons, okay? The business is not working. I'm exhausted. I'm getting burnt out. My actions and results do not match. My learning is not helping out. Technology is changing very fast. Market is changing very fast. I lost my job. Expenses are growing. Income is shrinking. There's still some more. You may be here because you have some time and you thought, why not spend it wisely? Or some more knowledge to chew upon. Sunday ka din hai, thodi si aur information gather ki jaye. Some new content for my training. So you may be a trainer looking for some new content. You may be in a similar space and to check out the competition. Or you may be here because you want to contribute. Or you may be somebody who's been dragged here. Or you may be somebody who's not very sure why are you here in the first place. Or it's a good question, why are you here? Or you may be somebody who says JLT, just like that. Or you may be somebody who wants to fulfill your dreams. Somebody who seeks support to build your business. Somebody who sees hope. This seems to be something new. Or you read my book and that had some answers. The mails you have been reading have been interesting. Maybe I talk some sense. And you are committed to live fully. And you're also committed to turn around your business. These were some of the reasons why you could be here. And you are most welcome. Let me just share with you what is there for you today in the next 1.5 to 2 hours. If you are a startup, there's a way forward for you. You can plan, target, and engage with your market. If you are an MSME, there's an opportunity for you to recalibrate. Take stock of where you are, re-engage with your market, have a go-to-market plan. And if you are an established business, even for you, here's an opportunity to recalibrate. Take stock of where you are, where your business is. Re-engage with your market. or maybe engage with the new market which has come up and create a go-to-market plan. All right. Now you might be wondering, who is Atul Puri? Right? Well, I'm not there in this photo. I'm the one who is the reason for the smiles on these faces. This is how I look like. I'm the founder of a platform called eGrowth, which is an ecosystem for small businesses. I'm also the creator of the eGrowth framework, which says a CEO is somebody who is consistently looking for opportunities to collaborate for excellence in business and larger opportunities in business. eGrowth has a platform. We started working on it in 2014 and it has been growing ever since. I'm also the creator of the leverage model, which is a model which helps you design your business. Something interesting that we did during the lockdown or during the COVID era was the CEO talks. While on 24th of March, the Prime Minister declared a lockdown in India, I declared a lock open. So from 25th of March till the last week of August, we had CEO talks every day, 152 CEO talks without fail, wherein we had entrepreneurs who came and spoke to other entrepreneurs about their journey, about their business. We also had a number of panel discussions where we invited industry bodies. I'm also the author of a book called Golf, Mastering Business Success. This is a book which helps you design your business. I'm also a part of an NGO called WE, World of Empowerment. So these are a few of the things that keep me busy. On top of it, I am here to help you design your business. Sales is an integral part of the design. And that is what I help you do. Right, and today we'll be talking about that. Now, why am I here? The only way for you to have a sustainable business is to ignite your sales funnel. And my only job is to help you design your business well. And I must tell you, I am on your side. So I am here because you are here. Let me tell you a little bit about the eGrowth story. So eGrowth, I used to work for a Fortune 50 company in 2014. This is when I thought that I wanted to do something for the small businesses. That is when I started interacting with the small businesses. And I started looking at how I can empower and enable small businesses. We started with the first event in November 2014 called eGrowth at Biz, and then continued to build the community. Today, eGrowth has a community, has around 35,000 business owners spread across the country. In fact, we've got a few who are from other countries as well. Right? This is a little bit about what has been keeping me busy. Now the next question, why design your sales funnel? The first reason for that is the business world is changing. Okay. So let us go back into history. So let us look at 2000. In 2000, this is primarily how we used to do business. We used to have a telephone. We used to send letters Aerogram used to have a colored envelope. We used to insert coupons in the newspaper. There used to be yellow pages. There used to be networking. The internet had just about come in. We used to participate in the trade shows. Mobile had just about come in. We call that as the brick and mortar world, where the business used to happen in the real world. We actually used to shake hands to conduct business. Over the next 15 years, things changed. And signs like these started becoming commonplace. So we started having online platforms, online tools. This is something what we call as the digital world. In a span of 15 years, from the brick and mortar world, the digital world started becoming a reality. There were applications which were there on mobile, SEO became important, Paytm was important. We also used to have something called as Bitcoin. And then come March 2020, in the next 5 years, we migrated from the digital world to what I call as the connected world. The handshake gave way to the handcuff. We got handcuffed to the mobile phone. All these applications became different. So this is how Facebook became. This was Amazon. Then we had Netflix, and then we had G for Google. So these four organizations, Facebook, Amazon, Netflix, and Google, put together are called FANG. They, between themselves, have the largest amount of data on this planet today. Practically, there is nobody who is left unaffected from these. And then we have the Apple and the Android. There are other platforms which kind of became marginalized on the mobile phone space. Then we have the Play Store and the YouTube. And then we have so many more platforms. Zoom is a relatively new entrant and has been growing power to power, strength to strength. And then we have Swiggy and Zomato, who are kind of starting to replace our kitchens. We also have Ola and Uber, who have started to replace our cars. And we've got Make My Trip and Oyo, who started to replace, rather help us when we're traveling. So our living spaces. And then we have Paytm and GPay, who are our digital money partners. And then there is another logo, which is called Jio, which has changed the way we use the internet, changed the quantum of internet that we use every day. And Zoom, SEO, and mobile, we've seen the increasing impact. This is March 2020. And now let us see, in a span of 6 months, what has happened. From the connected world, we've gone to the masked world. Quite a few things remain similar, and then there are a few new entries as well. Jio became bigger, mobile phone became bigger, Zoom became even bigger. Even e-growth became bigger. Email also became bigger. Arogya Setu came out of nowhere and has become very important and integral part of our life. And online telephony, or I would say the webinars, they have become an integral part of our life. Every day we end up attending some webinars, some online meetings. And this is called as the Namaskar world. In a span of 6 months, this is how we transitioned. These are some of the reasons why you should look at changing your the way you do business today. So now I'll just wait for a couple of minutes. If you've got any questions, you could probably raise your hand or just share what is it that you got from the conversation so far. So you can please raise your hand, we'll unmute you and you can share. Anybody? So there's an option for you to raise your hand. Fantastic. So if you don't have any questions, we'll move on. So I'm saying sales is a dying profession. And I've got a reason to say, so okay, great. We got two people who've raised their hands. Okay. Saril, can you please? Deepakji, please. So what is the question that you have?
I came purposely because this transition is taking place so fast. So I want to understand from the horse's mouth or the expert. So you are the expert in, going ahead. Your vision, I like it. And I want to see the transition, how it has gone so fast. And what are the corrective actions we need to take? Thank you.
Fantastic. All right. So out of what we just covered, what is it that you got?
Yeah, I received the basics now, that what are the fundamentals, what are changing,
right?
The parameters, and I want to see how we can take action on that. I need to learn that from you.
Fair enough. All right. Anybody else? There was somebody else also who raised his hand.
Yes, Atul, I have a question.
Yeah, Sunil, tell me.
Atul, you very rightly, reiterated last 6 months, the entire dynamics of, the business has changed. And the small entrepreneur who is in single capacity is unable to understand how to resonate to this particular change, because he is stuck badly with his own previous practices and the challenges which arises out of it. So is there any platform available where somebody can, take a break and see how he has to react to the change environment?
Right. Yeah. So there are quite a few platforms who are doing some good stuff. And we are also trying to do this a similar stuff. What is it that we've learned and how we can contribute? Yeah. Mr. Bajaj, you can please unmute yourself. Yeah. Please.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
You have in a short time told us how the world has transformed and transformed at an accelerated pace. We cannot continue with our successful way of doing business the way we were doing business. We will have to change, whether from the brick and mortar to digital or whatever it is. But we have to be adaptable to be sustainable. And the biggest takeaway from me, whatever you have talked till now, was you cannot afford to succeed using the same elements by which you have succeeded in the past.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
And thanks, sir. Thanks a lot for taking time out for rest of them. Sir, I would like to share with all of you, Mr. Bajaj, he is the vice chairman of Bajaj Auto. Sir, I would like to take a couple of minutes of yours later in the presentation, sir. All right?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, so we had some more people who raised their hand. Mr. Rakesh Jain. Mr. Rakesh Jain, if you can please unmute yourself.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
See, whatever the current scenario, you have really created a picture. My dear friends, see this picture. I would like to show you in the negative. Actual real picture will become afterward when you can do something more constructive, then you will enjoy the movie. This is such an introspective way and designing in your word, that whole message is being getting, we are getting your message. It is a wonderful message, my dear.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Mr. Vipin Sareen, you've raised your hand. If you can please share what you got.
I could interpret from your presentation is that rightly said, word is changing, and the old quote that things outside, the rate of change outside your organization is higher than inside your organization, and you need to change constantly. But now it is tremendously high. So collaboration is the key, I believe, in tomorrow's world, thinking your business from zero and collaborating, pulling your resources in terms of marketing, branding, other things also. This is my takeaway, that we should look like that.
Absolutely. All right, so let's move on. So I'm saying that sales is a dying profession. All right, so let us look at what is the sales life cycle. So the life cycle of a lead or a sale is that it starts where the customer or the prospect starts gaining awareness. He starts having interest in the product or the service. He starts considering our product or service. There is an intent to buy. Then he starts evaluating multiple options, and finally a purchase happens. In this, the awareness piece is called lead generation. The interest, consideration, intent, evaluation, all that is lead nurturing. Wherein we, as a business owner, our job is to keep feeding our prospect knowledge or different pieces so that he has a favorable response towards buying our services and products. And finally, the sales happens. Now, let me show you something really interesting. What I'm saying here is marketing has come of age. These steps still continue. So awareness, interest, consideration, intent, evaluation, and purchase still continue to be there. In the brick and mortar world, remember 2000, marketing used to be, as they say, toothless part of the business. They were only working on the awareness and interest, and to some extent, the consideration piece. Beyond that, it was the sales organization which was taking the prospect to finally a customer. But now with technology coming in, with customer behavior changing, things have changed. Marketing has become important right till the customer is evaluating the options. And sales has just got reduced to just a transaction. And in some cases, even that is not the case. Today, if all of us look at some of the products or services that we bought in the past, we got awareness, we got interest, consideration, intent, and evaluation. All that we did on Google. We would go to Google, compare products, look at specifications, get the answers, go to YouTube, see the videos, and at times maybe pick up the phone and speak to a friend, maybe speak to somebody, all right? So what has been happening is the customer has become in charge in the real sense. And then when the customer wants, he goes to Amazon and places an order over there. And Amazon has a supply chain or maybe the delivery engine behind it, which completes the transaction. All right? So now the way, so as some of you said in this previous conversation, that the way business used to happen and the way business is happening today are two different worlds. So if there are two different worlds, the tools which were effective earlier are not effective today, my friends. So when I'm saying sales is dying, that simply means the functions that a sales organization used to do need to be redefined. It is important that we look at retooling our organization. The set of tools which used to work 10 years ago, 15 years ago, don't function anymore. If we realize that today, we are still not very late. Okay, let's move to the next piece. Discovery is the in thing. Okay, I am reiterating it. Discovery is the in thing. Today, the customer discovers. So there used to be a time when Eureka Forbes, their people used to go to people's home, demonstrate a vacuum cleaner, educate the customer on how a vacuum cleaner works, and then conduct a sale. So there, the salesman was actually acting like a consultant, was actually the consultant, the advisor, the well-wisher of the customer. He used to guide the customer to buy something. And then finally the sale would happen. Today, with so many tools and so many options available, the customer takes the call, the customer discovers. So to say this, I would like to share some examples. So what it was and what it is. We still have Kirana Walas. From Kirana Walas to departmental stores or organized retail, as we would call it. The difference has been, when you go to a Kirana Walas shop, you say, I want atta, and then the Kirana Wala gives you atta which he pleases. In the departmental store, there is a complete department where the pulses and the staples are, and you can pick up whatsoever you want. So the customer is in charge, the customer is in control in this transition from the Kirana Wala to the departmental store. You actually walk into the store and do the conduct the transaction the way you want it, not the way the departmental store wants it. Utilities. We used to get printed bills for electricity, for water, for gas, and so on. Today, they've transitioned to self-service portals. We still get those bills. But paying those bills, we don't have to go and stand in the queues of their offices. We can simply go to the internet and make the payment at 1 o'clock in the morning, at 12 in the midnight, at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, anytime, on a Sunday, on a weekday, on a holiday, right? Let's look at the next one, ticketing and travel agents. They're actually almost an era of past. Means we for a train ticket, for a flight ticket, we needed to go to the travel agents and they would help us with it. Today we got travel portals where we can select, we can get the best deals and we decide. So the customer discovers. The customer is in control. Retail to online retail. So while we saw a shift of Kirana Wala to departmental store, now we have reached a stage where we don't even need to go to the departmental store if there are standard products. Big Basket delivers everything at home. Our milk is delivered at home. Our staples are delivered at home. Amazon delivers books to pins to electronic items, everything. online retail. Customer is in charge. He buys when he wants to buy. He buys what he wants to buy, where he wants to buy, right? Insurance agents. An insurance agent had to spend so much time convincing people why insurance, which policy, what differences. Actually, insurance agent would be the wrong word, insurance advisors. They are, even today, with all due respect, they are advisors, because most of us are not educated on how to handle our money. But yet there are options like Policy Bazaar or so many online options where the customer is the king. Advertising agencies. We move to self-service on Facebook. A lot of advertisement today is happening on platforms like Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram. So where the advertiser used to do so much and the customer does it himself. PR agencies. The new generation PR agencies are bloggers, video loggers, podcasts. Tailors to ready-made big bazaars. Government offices to online services. All right. So this is a great transition. And if we don't acknowledge this, and if we don't understand which way the customer is headed, like so many lines of business, our business is also heading towards a doom. And this does not have anything to do with Corona, my friends. This is only related to the way the world is moving. Corona is just a transitionary phase. It has in fact helped us to increase the pace of change. Had Corona not happened, at least 80% of those of you who are there on the call right now would not have been on Zoom. I started using Zoom for the first time only after the lockdown was declared, right? Now let's move on to another piece. Here's a study by McKinsey. Though it is on the American business, American continent, it's very much relevant to us as well. It says the great consumer shift, 10 charts that show how US, you can replace that with India, Indian shopping behavior is changing. Let's look at the 10 points. The first piece, digital shopping is here to stay. Millennials and high income earners are in the lead when it comes to shopping online. So high income earners, they value their time. Since they value their time, they don't want to spend their time going out, traveling, or going to a place and buying things. They would rather sit from their workplace or from their home in a couple of minutes, be done with it. Millennials, on the other hand, they are born with the mobile phone, with the internet. Most of us who are listening to this call right now, this class, are a pre-internet generation. We were definitely born before the internet came into India. Internet was launched in India on 15th of August 1995. We have just completed 25 years. And I would like to believe that all of you are more than 25 years of age. We were definitely not born with a mobile phone in our hand, right? Millennials, on the other hand, they were born with a mobile phone. So their thinking pattern is way different from ours. And I would like to point it out that our customers are millennials. So if our business is not oriented towards the millennials will go and buy where from the businesses which are oriented towards them. Consumers are switching brands at unprecedented rates. We are from a generation which were pretty loyal to our brands. Today, things are changing. There are new brands which are coming up. People are more conscious about quality, about features, about user experience. These are some of the reasons why they switch brands. Brands need to ensure strong availability and also convey value. Dhanda value ka khel hai mere dost. If we are not creating value in our business, we are losing out. It's not the market is shunting us out. We are losing out if we are not creating enough value for our customers. Consumers are changing how they shop in response to social distancing norms. Social distancing is definitely something which is a creation of Corona. That is something which has been contributed by Corona. That has also contributed in the way we do business. All right? Consumer shopping intent is focused on essentials. Okay? Consumers want value for their money, especially in essential category. Americans are changing how they spend their time at home. So we can replace this with human beings are changing how they spend their time at home. Americans are concerned about going back to regular activities outside the home. Human beings are concerned about going back to normal life. The great consumer shift trends vary by consumer segment. So some segments have been impacted very high, some are impacted low. I invite you to look at your business segment and take appropriate actions. The world is never going to be same again. Pre 25th of March in India is never going to come back. Here's another paper from McKinsey, which talks about consumer experience transformation. Today, the consumer is very much present about what he needs. When we were growing up, we were okay with whatsoever our parents gave to us. Today, that is not the case. I've got a niece who's 1.5 years old. 1.5 years old. She still cannot speak. She's just about started blabbering. And she knows what she wants to eat. She is categoric. If I give her something which she does not want to eat, she refuses to open her mouth. My friends, this is the generation. These are the people we're talking about. And our consumers are similar. We cannot stuff our stuff into their mouth. Let's see a couple of things. So customer experience transformation. There has to be a top management buy-in. Customer-centric strategy to ensure a shared vision. As the owners of the business, as the top management, we cannot have a business which is focused towards our business. It has to be focused towards the customer. Core customer journey, identify and transform by redesigning and digitizing the customer journey. Observe how the customer comes into your business, how the customer interacts with your business. And for that, ensure that all aspects of the journey are taken care of. At every step, you are either giving information, you are hand-holding the customer so that the customer graduates to the next level. Okay? Enable the transformation. We cannot wait for somebody else to come and do that for us. Establish a permanent live feedback loop from the customer. Our customers give us feedback, and it is important for us to process that feedback. If we shut our doors to the feedback, we are heading for doom. Take action on the feedback that you get. Now let me take you to another paper from Harvard Business Review. And this was a pretty old one. I think around 25 years old paper. Which says, acquiring a new customer is anywhere from 5 to 25 times more expensive than retaining an existing customer. Getting a new customer is way more expensive than retaining an existing customer. You can actually do more business than what you are doing today by just taking care of your existing customers. Increasing customer retention rates by 5% increases profits by 25 to 95%. Customer churn rate is the metric that measures the percentage of customers who end their relationship with a company in a particular period. All right. Our existing customers are our biggest assets. They are our brand ambassadors. They are our advocates. They are the ones who speak about us in the market. If they speak good, if they keep on coming back to us, we are in business. If our existing customer does not speak about us, does not speak good about us, then we're gone. So it's time to make the great shift, friends. So here's what I say. Speaking to the listening. What that means is listen to your customer. Your customer listens to you in a certain fashion. Expenditure to investment. Don't think that you are spending some money when you are spending in advertisement or in any other asset creation. Invest in your customers. My way or highway to customers' way. No organization can sustain a business if it has this kind of an attitude. Lo ya jao. Nothing, doesn't work. We have to be present to this fact that the customer pays your bills. You don't pay for the customer. All right. So now again, I'll open for some sharing. So if you want to share, please raise your hands and I'll be glad to listen to you or any questions or any remarks. Anybody would like to share something or ask a question?
Atulji, great presentation. You have really touched the masterpiece. Great job.
Thank you, sir. So I would like to share Mr. Harjinder Singh Cheema. He is the chairman of Cheema Boilers. who are the fourth largest boiler manufacturing company in India. So thank you, sir, for being here. Yeah. Yeah, Mr. Deepak Sidhay, please share what you wanted to share. Yeah.
Yeah, this is the actual reason why we came 11 o'clock on Sunday, to know why and how and what changes are happening. Little difficult to sink in the adjust. Brain immediately, but yeah. adjust. It's so difficult to change the position, you know. So, but anyway, it's a very good.
Thank you. Mr. Rakesh Jain.
Hello, Atul.
Yeah.
See the things, what I am telling you, or yeah, what please. I would like to tell everybody. See, whatever the introspection, line of introspection is really, we all are heading with you. This is the beauty. Because whenever the I will like host speak something, and we are the guest, just we are listening you, you are taking over the whole shipment in a forward in a such a way, there is no U-turn required to take. Means that further destination you are showing us. Thank you very much.
My pleasure, sir. Mr. Vij.
Yeah, thanks, Atulji.
Mere hum naam hai ye. Atul speaking. Anji, please.
I will be voicing your thoughts only. It was very encouraging to what you said, to listen to what you said. And the data which you presented is actually very mind-boggling. Knew these concepts, knew these directions, but the way you have said it, okay, this is the amount of impact, one, it really gets thinking. And the speed of change, earlier the speed of a vehicle used to be 40, 50, 60, now it is 100 plus. What you said, 25 years back internet was launched, and last 6 months the changes have happened. I think the order is the same. So the way you are explaining, we have to change our mindset, mind cannot be set, is very, very important. I'm actually thinking very, very differently after having heard you for last few minutes. Thank you, Atulji.
Thank you. Vinayji, you wanted to say something.
Yeah, ji. Atulji, this is really super. Very often we tend to forget. We deal with so many businesses and then people say, "Are yaar, sale nahi ho rahi. We are not getting the sales, this salesman, that salesman." Focus which you told us on how the role of marketing has increased dramatically and how that market has become about the customer discovering and how customer centricity and how you need to deal with that. I think it is an appreciation which all business people need to have, whether they are in manufacturing and services. So thank you very much for that. I think that's a very, very powerful set of statements which you have made today. If we absorb them and implement them in our businesses, we'll see a sea change in our results.
Awesome. Thank you. Anybody else? I'm just seeing. All right. So let's move on. So now, as I move on, I'll be sharing some business frameworks. Okay. The first one is an awesome one. Awesome. I would believe that 80% of us, or maybe more than that, are living, have this business model. This is called business by chance. The beginning happens something like this. Either we inherit the business, or we get into this business because of the experience that we have. Or we get into this business because of a new trend. And then there is a very dear reason, which is getting a pink slip. We have been working with somebody and one fine day we get a pink slip. Next day we become an entrepreneur. All right. Then comes the phase of growth. We form a company. We get some customers. And then get into this mode of sale. Doka panch. And then comes the struggle, wherein the receivables start mounting up. We start having consistent challenges with manpower. working capital becomes an issue. Margins start reducing consistently. I call this as business by chance. We've not really thought through before getting into the business. And then there is another kind of a business which is called business by design. We start with a design. This is the creation phase where the business is in the startup mode and it is driven by future. Kal ko ye business kaisa dikhai dega? What is the kind of enterprise I want to create? Who are the kind of customers we want to service? All right? Second phase is the development phase. This is the maintenance phase, which is driven by present. Aaj ke date mein kya? So we are driven by growth. And then the third phase is the diversification phase, wherein we monetize the assets. Either we duplicate the business or we get out of, exit the business. All right? Today, the way we are living or having businesses as if businesses are immortal. That is not the case. Businesses transform, businesses complete. All right? And I would like to share a typical kind of a business which I call as a leveraged business. These are businesses which experience exponential or explosive growth. What I mean by that is multi-dimensional growth. Their saleable product is their ability to leverage various resources. These are complex. They have multi-dimensional engagement and holographic relationships. Holographic relationship, that means things are not happening in a linear fashion. One after the other does not happen. There are many things which are happening simultaneously. Right? So there are multiple inputs, parallel processes, and multiple outcomes for these businesses. If you look at the stakeholders, their customers are stakeholders. And there are multiple customers, stakeholders who are customers. There are sellers, service providers, process owners, IPR owners, secondary sellers, tertiary sellers, buyers, consumers. Right? We'll be talking a little bit more about the leverage businesses today. Three secrets of a leveraged business. The first secret is to be the leverage quadrant player. Next couple of slides, I'll share with you what a leverage quadrant is. Okay. Cash flow quadrant, all of us would have heard. Thanks to Robert Kiyosaki, this is like ingrained. There are four quadrants, E, S, B, and I. Right? Employee, self-employed, business owner, investor. I have the same one I'm talking and I'm calling it as the leverage quadrant. The E quadrant is defined by active participation. The person in the E quadrant gets a salary. In the self-employed quadrant, there is linear progress. Contracts is what he works on. In the business quadrant, he starts leveraging resources. And turnover is how he measures his business. And then in the I or the investors quadrant, there is passive income. And majority of the income is passive. And dividend is how he measures his success. 90% of the people fall on the left-hand side. If not 90, maybe 93, but a vast majority of people. And they have a minor stake in the wealth of this planet. Their characteristic is they work alone. and they are selling time for money. Let us look at the right side. Less than 10% people are there on the right hand side. And they control more than 90% of the wealth on this planet. They are the ones who have mastered the art of leveraging their resources. And their businesses are driven by systems, not by people. Okay, let's move yet one step further. Let us look at, this is what I call as the leverage quadrant, the business quadrant. This is, the significance here is they have an action plan. I'm not talking about how effective is the action plan, but there is definitely an action plan. Leverage is an integral part. There are structures for practically everything in the business. There are systems which support the business end to end. All right. Now it is up to you to figure out in which quadrant are you playing. Now let me share one example of somebody who's playing in the leverage quadrant. So I've taken the example of Chaos. These two people, they started this company, I think around 8 years back. Today they have 80 outlets spread across the country. They have already got 8 rounds of funding. And they are not in the business of selling chai. They are in the business of creating experiences. What is it that they are leveraging? They are leveraging their ability to experiment. They are leveraging their connect with upwardly mobile population. They have systems and structures in place. They've got a franchise model. They're using technology and they are using supply chain. And this is what is keeping them growing. Corona or no corona, they are still up there. All right. Now let's look at another piece, the secret two. Business engagement. So here you see a tea seller. He is selling tea. So we just saw one set of tea sellers earlier, and here's another tea seller. He will give you tea, you will give him money, and that's the end of the story. Next one is a hunter. So this is a typical term that we hear in the networking circles. Okay, a hunter goes, hunts his prey, and comes back. And then we have a farmer. This is another term that we very often we hear in the networking circles. A farmer raises the crop. And this is the term which you would not have heard anywhere. This is called as the weaver. Weaver creates a piece of art. The terms that are there in the brackets are these. Tea is a transaction. So selling tea is a transaction. A hunter has a skill. So he uses his skill and also which ends up in a transaction. A farmer uses his skill, his knowledge and ends up in a transaction. A weaver, along with the skill and knowledge, he also uses the process. And that is what adds maximum value to his business. So let me give you an example. I shared with you earlier also, on the 24th of March, the Prime Minister of India declared a lockdown. Evening 8:30. And at that time, I declared a lock open. And at 10:22 in the night, I sent out an email saying that tomorrow morning onwards, we will be on Zoom. And starting 25th of March till the end of August, we had CEO talks every day. We had 152 talks in all. 21 industry bodies participated. We had participants from 6 countries. 250 subscribers joined. eGrowth has paid subscribers. 2 associations joined eGrowth. 1 batch of Ubuntu the Leverage program happened. The second one is ongoing right now. 30 members in inner circle. 5 MOUs signed. And we impacted around 8,000 entrepreneurs. What did we do? We just weaved businesses together. So this is the power of weaving businesses or weaving conversations or weaving engagements, my friend. The more you sharpen your skill of weaving businesses, further you would go. All right? Secret 3, go up the ladder. This is another thing which I use. I say that this is the hierarchy of sales. At the bottom level, there is a sale. 1 kilo 4 rupaye ka. This is how this lady sells her stuff. The second level is referrals. Nature is the best known referral agent. There are flowers which bloom. There are honeybees which keep on getting nectar from one flower, move to the next one in the process. They help in pollination. That is how the seeds get created. And that is how referrals happen in nature. Human beings also buy from here and we use it in our businesses. We use referrals to create more business for ourselves. This is just the second level of maturity. The third level of maturity is networking. It's like a farmer. The farmer raises the crop. He seeds, he weeds, he does everything what it takes to safeguard his crop, and then finally one day he harvests the crop. And the fourth one is leverage. This is where I'm talking about a very well-known company called Bajaj. They are the world's favorite Indian. Let me share something more about them. The Bajaj Group, it's been around for 95 years. So 95 years of service to India. It's one of the 10 top business houses in India. Interest in automobiles, electricals, engineering, financial services, travel and logistics. And as they say, loved in 70 countries. Bajaj Auto, Bajaj Electrical, Bajaj FinServ, Mukund Limited, Bajaj Alliance, Hercules Hosts, and their travel business, Hindustan Musafir. All right? Now, this is what a leveraged business is. They are into multiple businesses and are one of the beloved business houses in India. So at this stage, I would like to ask you if you got any questions. And I would like to ask Mr. Madhur if he would like to share something. Sir, so you need to unmute yourself. Mr. Bajaj, you need to unmute yourself. Okay, fair enough. Right. So anybody else would like to share, and then Mr. Bajaj will share. Yeah. So what did you get out of this conversation now? You can raise your hand and then you can speak. So Chima Saab, what did you get out of this conversation now?
I'm really glad. Very, very nicely done. You have touched all the points of what industry needs. Beautiful presentation. Please keep it up.
And what would you be taking back to your business, sir?
सबसे पहले तो वो जो मार्केट का है ना,
हाँ जी,
जो सेल्स और मार्केट डिफरेंस है उसकी, हाँ, मैंने फोटो कर ली है, स्क्रीनशॉट। अच्छा। सबसे पहले, हाँ, वो दिखाऊंगा अपनी टीम को कि आपको अब मार्केटिंग में जोर देना, सेल्स पे नहीं।
सर आपकी टीम के लिए मैं प्रेजेंटेशन कर दूंगा, मुझे इनवाइट कर लेना।
या श्योर, वी वुड लव, वी वुड लव टू इनवाइट
यू सर।
राजेश जी, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून।
या सो या राजेश जी, व्हाट वुड यू लाइक टू शेयर?
यप, सी इनफैक्ट लेवरेजिंग, यू नो, सिंस द लास्ट 6 मंथ्स आई हैव क्लोजली इंटरेक्टेड विद यू, leveraging is something which I am carrying forward a lot in my business. I am bringing a lot of experts onto my platform from different areas of industry. And let me share with you, you know, 2 years ago when I started as a consultant in HVAC, there were some of my customers who have now taken me on their board as an advisor for a greenfield project.
Wow.
So, you know, they were at one time my customers. Then I became a consultant to them, and now I am part of their inner team. They are putting a 600 crore project and a greenfield project, and I am, you know, their advisor. Yesterday we had almost a 3-hour webinar, and they have a consultant, they have an architect, and my 40 years of experience, what it has taught me, I am putting that into shape in this project. And yesterday the MD's son said, Rajesh, any new technology you're looking at, see first, what will you ask if you're buying it for yourself? So, you know, he's placed that trust on me. And it's an excellent new journey, which I have, as the first company I have become as an advisor.
Awesome. So, awesome. Congratulations.
Yep. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Mr. Bajaj.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, sir. Sir, first and foremost, thanks a lot for joining in. And we'd love to hear from you. How is it that Bajaj, so compliments to you, fourth generation into the business. This is really very few organizations. Aaj ki date mein bhai bhai ikattha kaam nahin kar paate. And here it is the fourth generation which is into the business. There is something which each one of us needs to learn from you, sir.
You're right. We have been very fortunate that God and my grandfather, Jamnalal ji Bajaj, who was known as the fifth son of Gandhiji, their values is something that we have imbibed. That is something which is in our genes, and that is what is making us together and continue. That's very important. So we give the credit to my grandfather and to, of course, who was a total Gandhian, and to God. I mean,
thank you, sir.
Without luck, I'm telling you, whatever you do, you need mehrbani of the Almighty. Okay. Secondly, now we have reached the number 3 position as far as market cap is concerned in the business houses, with 5 lakh crores business cap. So many of our new enterprises like Bajaj Finance, Bajaj FinServ, etc., who are giving financial services, people have perhaps heard of Bajaj Finance. They are in fact overtaken Bajaj Auto, which is our older company. Not that Bajaj Auto is not doing badly. I mean, Bajaj Auto is doing well, but Bajaj Finance has really taken over, and many of you would remember that a lot of awards have been given to Bajaj Finance and FinServ in terms of which is being looked after by my nephew Sanjeev Bajaj, my brother Rahul Bhai's son. What is important to know is you have to identify the weakest link in your chain. And weakest link in the chain in the modern times, in the changed times. Because everything has changed. I mean, whatever we considered as the weak link earlier now is changed to something else. And therefore, it is important that we do the SWOT analysis, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats, very honestly. Many people do not do it honestly. We have to do it honestly. Whatever are the facts, we must be able to see it so that we can overcome it. I can tell you from my perception, this pandemic is not going to go in a hurry. I hope it goes, but it will not. And so we have to face that truth that we are going to learn to live with this pandemic. And because of this pandemic, many of the things have become faster. So, I mean, you know, as somebody said, okay, you must look for opportunities in a crisis. And I would say Atul has, you know, shared his experiences, his learnings, and is sharing with us, which is, you know, I must be grateful to him on the behalf of all the listeners and audience which is there, because he is giving his heart and soul to us in terms of his experience and what he thinks is going to happen. My last point is, you have to have a passion, a fire in the belly. My uncle used to say, Kamlanji, do whatever you like best, but be in the best what you do. In a which do not, chances that, you know, the passion will not develop. The fire in the belly will not develop. You have to enjoy your business, or you learn to enjoy your business. It's like we have to learn to enjoy our wives. I'm joking. We have to learn to enjoy where we are. Many times we do not have a choice. Jab kaam chahiye to fir kuch bhi kaam. I mean, I was reading yesterday that MBAs engineers are doing menial work. What to do? I mean, they have to carry on with the incomes. But those who are fortunate, who are, instead of taking away a job, they are giving up. It's again important to follow the mentor model. I mean, all of you are well across that, but many of your children would be in the entrepreneurial stage. And it is very important to handhold. You handhold them, somebody else handholds them, but mentoring is something which is crucial according to me, because the person has got bookish knowledge, but he has still not seen the world and the implications of the world. So Atul, if you have any questions, or if the panelists or the audience has any question, I would be very happy to answer them. But
awesome. Yeah.
God has been great. We have been lucky to be where we are. We hope to continue this way, but relationship is something, relationship not only within our family, because we consider our entire 20,000 workers part of our family. And that is why we did not remove a single person. And fortunately, while shareholders were cursing us for having a lot of spare cash, and my brother did not know as the chairman how to answer those questions, people were saying, leverage 20,000 crores you have, you can get 60,000 and have a big project of 80,000 crores. But he said, I like the feel of money under my pillow. Some of you may have read that or heard that. Now they do not speak like that. These monies which were saved is coming handy to keep our staff intact. And tomorrow the same staff will hopefully be thankful, grateful to us and do much better for us and take us to new heights. Thank you, Atul.
Yeah, great. So there's a question. There are a couple of people who want to ask questions. Sunil, you can please unmute yourself and ask the question. And I think...
thank you very much, Atul.
Yeah.
For giving me golden opportunity to put a question in front of respectable Madhur sir. Sir, thank you very much for, you know, giving opportunity to all of us to put a question. My question is, sir, I am a small business coach. I am doing the hand-holding of business owners.
Very good.
And all these business owners, those who are very small, and they see a dream to become a big corporate house. So could you give us a small, you know, milestone, few milestone they should follow so that they can resonate with your success story, sir?
I'll give you a few mantras which I believe should work. Firstly, there is no shortcut to hard work. Atul will be the first to agree with that, and I hope you will also agree with that.
Definitely, sir.
There is no shortcut to hard work. You know, you can't just imagine things happening on their own. You have to make them happen. Secondly, I would say that values are important. People think that, you know, if I want to be rich in 2 days, I'll have to do garbage. You can't be rich in 2 days by being honest and following certain values. But I believe that in the long term, it is the values. Bajaj is there because of its values. Bajaj is known and got the goodwill because of our values. We believe, and that is why our insurance is doing very well, because we have been amongst the first to settle the claims. I mean, and people say that they don't create disputes, etc. If we feel that the guy's house is destroyed and deserves the money, give it right away. Why wait?
Awesome.
Lastly, I would say that we need more people like you, sir, who can hold the hands of these people who are budding people. Otherwise, there is a very large percentage who are failing. I'm sorry to put it that way, but you know it. A large number are failing because they don't have the wherewithals. I have been saying that, you know, before you become an entrepreneur, try and have a job for 4 or 5 years. Now, I can't say that because there are jobs. So how do I mean, a person would just say that, sir, give me a job. I agree with you. But when there are less jobs and a person has to become an entrepreneur, then the best thing is to follow certain models, like if you have heard of BYST, Bharatiya Yuva Shakti Trust, which is controlled by the daughter of President of India, Venkatraman. Lakshmi Venkatesan is her name. She works from the office of CII, Confederation of Indian Industry, but she has held thousands of startups, and you may get a few tips from her. She would be very happy to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So nice of you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Rakesh Jain, you have a question? Mr. Rakesh Jain, you have a question? And Mr. Vipin Sareen.
Rakesh Jain, unmute yourself.
Okay, yeah, I did it.
Yeah, okay. Now I can hear you.
Okay. Mr. Atulji.
Yeah.
First, I would like to say the thank you. And now I would like to ask Madhurji. Madhurji, it is my privilege. I'm from Vardha. I studied Mahilashtra Madhyamik Vidyalaya, where the Kamal Nayanji, I sat just beside the Kamal Nayanji. And my grandfather, and so many things, people are really connected. My Kaku means that my aunt, she served near about throughout life for a Mahilakshmi Madhyamik Vidyalaya.
Wow.
So now I would like to ask you, Madhurji, it is really lucky and it is my privilege because of the Atul, I could able to reconnect you. I'm at Mumbai. I'm working as a executive coach for family managed businesses, mentor, as well as the visionary. My question is there, I'm really working since long, but I never ever incorporated still today, fourth generation. I could able to sustain first, second, third, but when the fourth generation is a third generation itself is a challenging, very, very challenging, very crucial challenge are happening there. But how you could able to people further move and enter in the fourth generation? That is a really secret story for me because I have never ever gone through that in my career as a family managed business consultant, coach, and mentor. Please tell me.
You are absolutely right. 98% of the people do not reach the fourth generation together. So we are in the very, very low minority. And I believe it is three things. The values which were imbibed through my grandfather, through Gandhiji. I think Gandhiji is still very relevant. I mean, he may have lived 150 years ago. It's, as you know, it's his 150th anniversary. But he's so relevant even today. And the top leaders have said that we have followed the teachings of Gandhi. So value systems, that is one thing which many of the families are forgetting. For them, money is all that is there to value instead of the other way around. So value system is one. Second is, of course, I would consider luck. I mean, you may say that aapke lakeeron mein likha hai ki, but God has been kind to us. I would say that it's you know, without God's kindness, we believe that we would not have reached so well. So that is the second thing.
Great.
Third is, we have been lucky to get, you see, we, the Bajajis, have been born with the Bajaj blood. But what about the ladies? And I tell you, in many of the cases, it's the ladies who create a trouble. I'm sorry if the ladies are with me, because they're coming from outside. Their culture is different. Their ways are different. Their priorities are different. They want their husbands and their sons to top it all and so on and so forth. So what we have been able to do is, we are lucky to get very, very good wives. We all have one wife.
great. Hello, Madhuji.
They have been able to imbibe, appreciate, and adopt the culture and the principles of our family, which has kept us together. In this lockout, I'm very happy to tell you that I'm staying in Pune, where Bajaj Auto is, where in complete lockdown, we don't go out. We don't allow people from outside to come in. I'm staying with my wife, my daughter, her husband, and my grandson. And we are having a great time. I mean, you know, we are not happy with what we read. So my daughter has stopped putting the news channel on the TV. But for us, it's like a hill station. But is basically the values which have kept us together.
Fantastic. Please, thank you, sir.
Please do not undervalue values. Please do not do that.
Thank you, sir. I'll invite Mr. Rajan Arora to ask. Mr. Rajan Arora is an industrialist from Nawanshahr in Punjab. They're one of the largest suppliers to Walmart in India for food products. So he had a question on family-run business. Mr. Rajan Arora? Rajan ji, please unmute yourself. Okay, Mr. Rajesh Budraj.
Yep, okay.
Yeah, please,
thanks,
please.
Thanks, Atul.
Yeah, Rajan ji, please be ready. Yeah.
Hi, Madhur.
Hi, Rajesh.
Good. Of course, I remember the lovely days we spent together when we worked at the Anga project. We traveled for that Panchayati Women program also.
Yes.
I still remember that was one of the life's best experience I got. And of course, you know, talking with Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, and you know, we used to sit together. And a great thing I used to find about him is he was open to listening to suggestions. He's such a big man, but he used to open. My question, part of it you've already answered, you know, about making money to holding values. Now, you know, as the generations go down, you know, as from Jamnalal Bajaj to etc. and down to you and your children.
Yes.
How do you see today's mantra outside in the world is somewhat different. People are looking at making quick money, get huge valuations, get huge funding, take their money out, sell it off. Now, how have you held your flock? You know, your children, of course, you know, is there in the genes. So, but still that thing in the mind would be coming at times with people, you know, I want to make a fast buck. Because India is a place you can make a fast buck for sure. So your thoughts on that?
We have never differentiated between boys and girls. Now, there is an act which equates girls with boys, but we never did that. In fact, I have given more of my wealth to my daughters. I have got two daughters. Mm-hmm. Then what I keep myself. Mm-hmm. And we are having going to have trust, because in the future years, I have no doubt that there will be what is called estate duty. Mm-hmm. So whatever wealth you have, 40-50% will go in estate duty after your death.
Yep.
So the fact that we have never differentiated, and we have seen what has happened to many of the ladies where men are dominating. And the history is because of our physical strength, we dominated them and then made rules accordingly, where women were sort of behind. And, you know, I was a chairman of the Women's Empowerment Committee of CII, where I saw such powerful women. I said, I'm changing the name to Men's Empowerment Committee, because there were such powerful women, and I'm so glad that women are doing so well. And I'm so glad this law has come where there's no differentiation between women and men. But we did this much before the law came.
Mm-hmm.
Even with our workers, we have been more than fair with them. We consider them as human beings. Yes, we listen to them. We listen to our customers, whether India or abroad. And that is why we are known as the favorite guys of the world, because 70 countries love us, and we are leaders in 22 different countries with our products. So we are very diversified, but again, the relationship amongst the different family members is just doesn't happen, you know, during certain festivals. Forget the pandemic for the time being, but here, pandemic also, birthdays and all, we celebrate through the online Zoom devices like what we are doing now. Festivals, we come together. We have great respect for elders. During Diwali, each of the younger siblings does pranam to the elder sibling. These are very small things, but I can give you more examples, but these are small things which work. According to me, they have a value. It seems very simple. So kya hua, bade bhai se pranam ko pranam kar diya, to kya badi baat ki? Hai badi baat. Hai badi baat. Aap badon ko jhukenge, to hai badi baat. And that's how we have kept our relationship. And that is why we hope that we continue with like this. I don't know what will happen to our fourth generation. The children are very, very small, 4 years old. Or my two grandsons are 4 years old and others are there. But we hope that we continue with the fourth and fifth generations also. Why not? Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Rajan Arora has got a question. Rajanji, are you there? Rajanji, are you there?
I don't see him.
He wasn't talking to me. All right, fine. So, okay, so we'll move on. Rest of the ones who have any questions, you please put it in the chat box. After some time, if we have an opportunity and if Bajaj sir has some time, we'll again ask him those questions. I'll ask those questions on your behalf.
All right.
Thank you, sir. It's been really, so especially in today's world, when value system. So I think value system is the same, whether it is for the business or for the family or for the individual. We cannot have separate value systems, which you have very, very, you've established it really well. So thank you for sharing that, sir. And thanks for choosing to, sir, thanks for choosing to continue to serve India. Many a times people who have money, they choose to go abroad and settle there. India has lost a lot of wealth just because of this one reason. So thank you for choosing India.
We are proud Indians.
Yes, sir. Rajanji, if you are there, last call for you. Else we'll come back. In some, you can just ask the question. All right. Okay, no worries. We'll move on. Okay, so here's a small introduction to Mr. Bajaj. Generally, it happens the other way around. This time, it is happening the other way around. he's the vice chairman of Bajaj Auto, chairman of Maharashtra Scooters Limited, director of many or maybe all of the Bajaj Group companies. He is on the national, he's the national council member for CII. He has got a Vikas Ratna award from the International Friendship Society of India. He's the past president of SIAM, which is Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers. He's the past president of Maratha Chamber of Commerce and Industries, Pune. He's the CII's Western Region Chairman and quite a few more things.
This is Maratha Chamber.
Yeah, Maratha Chambers, yeah. Absolutely. So when the going gets tough, the tough get going. So I'll take you through the leverage model. So this is something which I created last year when I realized that most of the businesses, rather 80% of the businesses, they collapse within 3 years of coming into existence. And the major reason for that has been that they are not designed well. So I created this model, which is about designing the business. So it has four elements to it. The first one is future, which is the soul of the business, which we very well, vividly, we could see the soul of Bajaj Enterprises right now. The lifeline, which is the product or the services of the business, the opportunity or the market where you're serving it, and the game, which is the process. All right. So this is something what I say. Business is the game played within a 6-inch arena. The space between your ears and projected to the world. All right. So let's play golf. Game, opportunity, lifeline, and future to have a highly leveraged business. This was a photo which was clicked in 2007 in Kauai Island, which is the North Island in Hawaii Islands. I never knew that I would be using it like this. So putting things in perspective, it starts with the design. Okay. So the create, the design, the leverage model. Development is the e-growth framework. And diversify is the normal mergers and acquisitions. Okay. So we'll speak a little bit more about the leverage model now. Okay. Now, it's very important for you to design your business. So when I'm saying, and it's never too late. They say even God allows U-turns. Business, so we've just established that business dynamics are changing rapidly. Leverage is the new glue for business. I'm just repeating it again. Three secrets of the leverage business are: be the leverage quadrant player, weave business engagement, step up the hierarchy of sales. And then four elements of the leverage model are game, opportunity, lifeline, and future. Right? So design brings workability. And it also brings a state change. What next? The next is, I'll be leading a program called the Leverage Model Blueprint. This is a program which helps you to create a blueprint for your business. It helps you re-examine, retool, reboot, and restart your business. Okay, I'll tell you more about it in the next couple of slides. First, is Mitlesh ji there? So Mitlesh ji, he is into international business, logistics rather. He's the privileged first student of leverage model. This is what he had to say about the leverage model. We were quite successful in our international business, logistics business since 2012. We were not able to systemize the processes. After training from Atulji, our shortcomings in process were visible to us. We clearly understood our strength areas, able to emphasize more on planning before execution. Sorry, what did I do? Okay. So able to emphasize more on planning before execution to reduce mistakes, able to systematize our process. At the end, I suggest new businessmen or aspiring businessmen to get trained to reduce risks and uncertainties. We also have Mrs. Sharda Bhatia and Mrs. Krishna Merchant who are into business of fashion
accessories. So he will be back soon.
I was wondering what happened.
Yeah, he's coming. Adulji, are you there?
I'm there, sorry.
Yeah, okay, carry on.
Yeah. Yeah, so Mrs. Sharda Bhatia and Mrs. Krishna Merchant, they are partners in a business called Rustic Blend. They are from Mumbai. Then we've got Mr. Satya Gupta. He is the NGN guru or the next generation networks guru. He's a telecom player. He was a deputy secretary with Ministry of Telecom, Government of India, from where he retired. And right now he's running a public-private partnership with BSNL and creating Wi-Fi hotspots in rural India. He's also running a couple of other NGOs. He also has an enterprise called SAM Advisors, which offers government services as government regulations as a service. All right. We also have Mr. R.K. Mishra over here, who is the CEO of this company. So now let me share a few road tests or how I have been building the enterprise. So here are some images. The one in the middle, this was the first ever training that we conducted in November 2014 called eGrowth at Biz. This was in Mumbai. Once I conducted this, I realized that this, I could not continue in a corporate business any long. I had to start doing something for small businesses. And rest is history. In 2015, I quit that company and I joined a startup. In 2017, I quit the startup also and got on its own throughout. So here you see images from Bombay, Pune, Thane, Ahmedabad, Delhi, Gurgaon, different places. All right. First thing what I did in 2017 when I quit my job is that I went on a road trip so that I could understand what the pains the business goes through. I went on a road trip to Punjab. So these are some images from Punjab. In April 2017, I went on a road trip to Western India. So here, Madhu sir, this image in the center, this is from Maratha Chamber. So at Senapati Bapat Marg, I organized an event there called The Road Ahead. So I'm sure your photograph is there over here. And I know that this place also has one of the halls, which is named after the Bajaj family.
That's correct.
So thank you for contributing or create, I won't say creating, but yes, contributing to such a an institution. Maratha Chamber is definitely a big institution in Western India to help the industrialists. All right. So these are various places. So I went right up to Kolhapur, Sangli, Satara, and then obviously Jalgaon, Nasik. I also went to Indore, all that stuff. In about 19 days, I traveled around 7,000 kilometers. And this was a great experience. And then again in 2018, we partnered with Startup India for their Uttar Pradesh Yatra. And these are some images from there. We organized 5 boot camps across the state of Uttar Pradesh. And then in 2019, we organized a boot camp for the tribals in Jharkhand at a place called Jadugura, just outside of Jamshedpur. So these are some images from there. Right now, they have set up an organization which grows organic vegetables, and these vegetables get exported to Middle East. We've been doing a lot of stuff in working with entrepreneurs. On top of this, I have been a charter member of TAI. So here are some images. The one on the top left is at the Commissioner of Industries, Himachal Pradesh, Shimla. On the left-hand side, middle one is at Kanpur, so with TAI Uttar Pradesh. The one middle on the right-hand side is TAI Udaipur. On the right-hand side, top, here is the patriarch from Dalmia Bharat Group. So we did a boot camp for the Dalmia Bharat Group companies. Okay. And then on the bottom right is the inauguration of the leverage model last year. And on the left one is the event what we organized for women entrepreneurs. So here are some images that we've captured for the activities that we've been doing specifically for women entrepreneurs. We have been organizing a flagship program called Celebrating Womanhood. So we did it in 2018, 2019, as well as in 2020, we did it on the 8th of March. And after that, the lockdown started. So that was the last physical event that we organized. And we're committed to women taking a first role or a larger role in the business ecosystem of India. And these are images from last year when we launched the leverage model. All right. So here's a little bit more about the leverage model blueprint. We'll be covering 3 pieces. The first piece would be the new world order. So I gave you a glimpse today of the direction in which the world is headed. There's a lot more to it. And if you're not designing your business according to the new world order, then you're definitely missing something. The second piece is the leverage paradigm. what all is it that you can leverage and how do you leverage? How does leverage become an integral part of your business? And the third piece is what's in it for me? So these three components is what will be delivered to you in the leverage model blueprint. We are going to deliver it over 3 days, 2 hours every day. The first one will be on the 30th of September, wherein we'll cover the changing world dynamics, the 21st century business, futuristic business design principles. See, I'm talking about the design principles. I'm not talking about tactics. All of you are business owners and you are masters in your game. What I'm trying to impact is how you look at the design aspects, which are going to impact for 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, or maybe the next generation as well, right? Next is the leverage paradigm. Design perspective to business, inherent nature of business, some business fundamentals, the leverage model and introduction. This will be on day two on the 1st of October. Then on the third day, which is the 2nd of October, we'll have the leverage model in detail. So we'll take you through future, the soul of your business, product, the lifeline of your business, market, the opportunity for your business, game plan, putting the blocks together. All right. And then on top of it, there would be some bonus topics which we would cover here. This is the economics angle to the business, the fourth industry revolution, the India story. And I would also conduct a micro surgery of your product offering. Theory of constraints and the abundance mindset. Okay. All put together, this would have a value of say around 60,000 rupees. On top of it, you would also have access to a number of mentors who are there on eGrowth. Mr. Bajaj, he was talking about the value of mentorship in the current set of business. And Mr. Bajaj, I'd like to share with you, we are incorporating that in our whatsoever possible manner. So right now, thank you, sir. So right now, what you see here are six of them. Based on the industry that you are from, we will be able to align you to somebody who's a master in that space and you can seek some inputs from the person. All right. In terms of value, I can't actually put a value to this because this is an invaluable asset. Mr. Chima is there on the call right now. Mr. Budhiraja, he's there on the call right now. The others, I don't think they're on the call right now. Mr. Chima, he's the fourth. He owns the fourth largest boiler manufacturing company in India called Chima Boilers. Mr. Budhiraja, he is a 1976 pass out from IIT Kharagpur, is a specialist in HVAC. Mr. Virendra Ingle, he is a specialist in franchise model. He's from Pune. Okay. And Dr. G.V. Kumar, he is a specialist in psychology. He's from Chennai. He has worked with the Chennai port and is he also works with BYST. All right. Mr. Subdeepak Malwai, he's from Mumbai. He is a transformation and a healing coach, and he's been at it for around 40 years. Mr. Shripad Kulkarni, he runs four businesses which are into sheet metal components and paints and abrasives. He is also the founder of a platform called BBN Global, which is Brahman Business Network Global. He's from Nasik. So like this, we've got mentors who specialize in certain areas and we'll be able to support you connecting to them. All right. So if we put a notional value of just 10,000 rupees, so what you will be getting in this leverage model blueprint is a total value of around 70,000 rupees. And the offer is only rupees 7,000 if you opt for it today. And I know we're in India, this may not be the best thing what you are looking at. So here's something really. So you can go to businessbydesign.in/offer and you can book your slot. And as you go and book your slot, let me give you great news. This is available to you at only 1,999 rupees. Okay? If you got any questions, I'll be glad to answer them. The schedule is day one is 30th of September, Wednesday, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Day two is 1st of October, Thursday, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Day three is 2nd October, Friday, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. All right. Go to this link, businessbydesign.in/offer and book your slot right away. And there is a fast action bonus as well. This is a strategic leverage breakthrough session. So the first 10 people who pay now, I will spend around half an hour with you to deal with the concerns that you have in your business. And I must definitely tell you that I'll be able to add some value, either by way of the knowledge that I've gathered or by way of the contacts that I have. So I'll be able to get you connected to somebody who can help you. Okay. So I'll help you create a great future for your business, get valuable contacts and some actionable inputs. So if you put all this together, it'll be around 80,000 rupees and is available to you at 1,999. So please go and make the payment. And while I'm here to answer the questions, I must tell you that the segments from which we've had business participants today are wannabe entrepreneurs, work from home, self-employed, professionals, startups, retail, online retail, distribution and wholesale, consumer services, learning and development services, B2B services, industrial services, manufacturers, importers, exporters, advisors, and consultants. All right. There are some people who had sent me some questions. So I thought I'll just take those questions and then I'll just open it up to all of you. For innovation, there were some questions that how do we create new opportunities? How do we adapt with need and change? How do we have exponential growth through leveraging tasks? Wish to seek on looking at things differently to turn around the business. So all what I can say is if you look at the leverage model, we talk about the future and then the lifeline or the product that you offer, the market that you want to serve and the game plan that you have, all right? So when you're talking about the future, it is not just about what you want to do. It is equally important for you to figure out what is your temperament? What is it that you are designed to do? Based on that, you look at what are your strengths, which areas you can contribute the maximum. Take a business of that kind. Don't do a business just because somebody else is doing it. So thanks for raising your hands. I'll just come back to you. Next is scale up is another important thing. So I promise you in this program, we will be addressing scale up as well. All right. Lead generation, that was my promise. So getting leads, more, getting more projects, searching for good customers, finding new clients, getting more registrations for your programs, how to turn inquiries into clients. So for all of them, my one single point answer is value your existing customers, give more value to them. If they are happy, they will get you more customers. They will come back to you. All right. You may probably not have to spend any money on advertising beyond that. Okay. Lead generation, reaching out to schools and parents, again, the same thing. Continue engaging with your existing customers. That is very important. Network building. Again, the same thing. How to reach out to concerned person of the company. whosoever you know in the company, make relations, listen to him. Don't try to impose yourself upon the other person. Listen to the other person. So develop your ability to listen. Develop your ability to empathize. All right? Many people just inquire and don't turn up. The people who don't turn up after inquiring, that means that you have not addressed what they want to listen. You have not addressed what are they asking you. So it is a good idea to go back to them and ask them, what is it that you've not got? All right? Building a strong customer base. You already, even if you have a single customer, he is a strong customer. Okay? Value the customer. Marketing communication, effective marketing, marketing support, new businesses, brand establishment, all this is a case, as I say, dhanda value ka khel hai mere dost. All right. This was it, what I wanted to share in the presentation. I'll just take you back once again to the link so that you get it. So businessbydesign.in/offer. Okay. I'm stopping the sharing and I'll take the questions now. Yeah, Mithlesh ji.
Sir.
Haan ji, please. So Mithlesh ji happens to be the first person who opted for the leverage model, and this was last year. Sir, please share what was available to you after you participated, and what would you recommend the others?
In fact, Atul ji ko main pichle kaafi saalon se janta hoon, aur jab inki explanation aur samjhane ki capacity mili, to unko kai bar maine bola, aap mujhe train karo. और ऑल्दो हम लोग साथ बैठे रहते थे, बाहर भी घूमने जाते थे, तो इन्होंने जब पहली बार ये प्रोग्राम बनाया, मैंने कहा पहला आदमी मैं सीखने के लिए हूंगा। और यकीन मानिए कि ऑल्दो 10 साल पहले से मैं बिजनेस में हूँ, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बिजनेस में, इंटरनेशनल ट्रांसपोर्ट लॉजिस्टिक्स में, इनके एक्सप्लेनेशन के बाद जो इन्होंने डिजाइन बिजनेस का किया, उसके बाद से इतनी सारी गलतियां मेरे अपने बिजनेस में मिली सुधारने के लिए, कि वही काफी था जो कि उसने काफी चेंज किया मेरे अपने बिजनेस को। तब से लेके एक बात तो समझ में आ गया कि खाली ज्यादातर लोग, जो हम जैसे लोग जो फर्स्ट टाइम बिजनेसमैन हैं, मैंने मधुर सर से एक चैट में क्वेश्चन भी पूछा है, थैंक यू मधुर सर कि आप इसमें हैं, मुझे इस बीच में अतुल जी एक क्वेश्चन सर से पूछने दीजिए। वो क्वेश्चन ये है कि हम लोग जो फर्स्ट जनरेशन बिजनेसमैन हैं, उनकी प्रॉब्लम होती है कि हमें बिजनेस को अच्छे वक्त को तो हैंडल करना आता है, बुरे वक्त को हैंडल करना बहुत कम आता है, बिकॉज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम कहाँ से आते हैं पता नहीं चलता है। तो जो पुराने बिजनेसमैन हैं, जो जनरेशन से सीख रहे हैं, वो अपने फादर और ग्रैंडफादर से वो सीखते हैं कि बुरे वक्त को कैसे डील किया। अगर इसमें दो चार मंत्र हम लोगों को दे दें तो बाद में बहुत ही काम, ये मौका मैं छोड़ना नहीं चाहता लोगों के लिए, क्योंकि ना ये ऐसी चीज है जो हम लोग नहीं सीखते हैं, सीख के आए होते हैं, और ये हम लोगों के लिए बहुत अच्छे दिन तो बहुत आते हैं और उसको हैंडल करना फिर भी लोग सीख लेते, बुरे वक्त एकदम डिस्ट्रॉय कर लेता है नए बिजनेसमैन का करियर। तो अगर मौका मिले तो सर ये जरूर हम लोगों को आज बताने की कोशिश करें। और अतुल जी के लिए सर ये जो है, इनके सिस्टम के बाद जो इन्होंने टीचिंग किया, उसके बाद से इतने सारे चेंजेज हुए हैं कि आज की डेट में हम बिजनेस को देखने का जो प्रस्पेक्टिव, वो काफी चेंज हुआ है हमारा। हर चीज हम लोग सोच के अब करना शुरू कर चुके हैं। और जब जिस तरीके से इन्होंने रेफरल से लेके लिवरेज तक का बताया ना, तो पहले क्या है कि जब आपका सेल्स बहुत स्ट्रांग होता है तो अपने पूरा का पूरा ताकत लगाते, मैं तो अपने सेल्स के दम पे कंपनी रन कर लूंगा। बाद में पता चला है कि सेल्स खाली कंपनी रन नहीं कराती, उसके साथ जितनी चीजें होती हैं, जब तक वो सारे अलाइन नहीं होंगे आपकी कंपनी नहीं चलने वाली है। और ये हम लोगों के साथ हो चुका है कि बहुत ऊपर जाके कंपनी अचानक ही डाउन होने लगी थी। बाद में इसमें देखे कि जितनी चीजें इन्होंने बताई ना, सच में वो सारी चीजें थी जिसके कारण की कंपनी स्टक भी हुई, उसके बाद नीचे भी जाना शुरू हो गया। Fantastic. आज की डेट में वहां हमें बड़ा फायदा हुआ। थैंक यू अतुल जी, थैंक यू मधुर सर आपके उसके लिए।
हाँ जी मुजाज साहब, प्लीज
वांट मी टू स्पीक,
इफ यू कैन प्लीज आंसर दैट विल बी ग्रेट सर।
आपको लगता नहीं है कि बजाज ग्रुप में अप्स एंड डाउन्स आए होंगे? हमारे बहुत सारे अप्स एंड डाउन्स, क्राइसिस सिचुएशंस आए। मेरा रिक्वेस्ट आप लोगों से यही होगा कि ट्राई एंड सर्वाइव दोज बैड टाइम्स. बैड टाइम्स विल कम. नोबडी विल बी लेफ्ट आउट ऑफ द बैड टाइम्स. बट द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टू सर्वाइव दोज बैड टाइम्स. Lower your standard of living if you have to lower your standard of living, but survive those bad times. And for surviving those bad times, please don't over leverage. What people think is that I want to become Rockefeller or I want to become Tata's in the next 10 years. You can't do it. Because that means that you will over leverage. If the bank is willing to give you extra money, that's called leveraging. You are using your 10,000 crores, you get 80,000 crores or whatever it is. You are over leveraging. If anything goes wrong, you are not able to pay your capital plus interest. So you have to go slow but steady wins the race. Is my motto. And I have seen Southeast Asia was in trouble because what they did was they took short-term loans and used it for long-term investments. So they could not return back and became bankrupt. You know, it's more important to have a cash flow rather than profit. I mean, between the two, I would choose cash flow to profit. You can have a profitable business and yet go bankrupt because you don't have money. So my mantra to you would be patient, don't be over ambitious. Be ambitious, but don't be over ambitious. Don't over leverage. Keep something for the rainy days and suffer the bad times. I'm telling you, those who are able to suffer these bad times in the pandemic, and they will come out much better once this is through. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Anybody else